So, hello students. In the last lecture, we were discussing about the reversible adiabatic process and we derived three relationships for the adiabatic process. That is, PV raised to power gamma is equal to constant, TV raised to power gamma minus 1 is equal to constant, and the third one is P divided by T raised to power gamma over gamma minus 1. So, these three relations you should always remember, because with the help of these three relations, we can calculate the missing parameter. For example, if we are given with P1, V1 and P2, then we can calculate the value of V2. And suppose if we are given with P1, T1 and we are given with T2, then we can calculate the value of P2. That is how we can use these equations. Now let us calculate the value of delta Q using the first law of thermodynamics for this reversible adiabatic process. We know that the value of delta Q is equal to dU plus PdV, and dU is given by mCV dt plus PdV. Now in case of a reversible adiabatic process, this PdV is W1 to 2, which is given by P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over gamma minus 1. So we can integrate this equation. When we will integrate this equation, we will get Q1 to 2. And here we will get mCV T2 minus T1, whereas in case of PdV, we will get P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by gamma minus 1. So once again, writing the first term as it is, but in place of P1 V1, I am writing MRT1. This is the gas equation. PV is equal to MRT. And similarly, here I am writing MRT2. Divided by gamma minus 1. Now, what we have done here is we have taken R divided by gamma minus 1 out from both the terms, and M is also taken outside, and we are left with T1 minus T2. And this term MCV T2 minus T1 is left as it is. So you can see here, now Q1 to 2 is given by MCV T2 minus T1. P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over gamma minus 1. We started from this equation only in the previous slide. So we were here actually MCV T2 minus T1 divided plus MR gamma minus 1. Now what is this MR gamma minus 1? So you can see it here. We know that CP minus CV is equal to R. We can divide each term by CV, and we went divide by CV, this first term becomes gamma, CV by CV becomes 1, and R over CV. So R over gamma minus 1 comes out to be CV. So in place of R over gamma minus 1, I have put CV here, M into T1 minus T2, and MCV T2 minus T1. So you can see it is T1 minus T2, and it is T2 minus T1. So naturally the sign of both will come out to be different, or otherwise what we can do is we can write it as MCV T2 minus T1 minus MCV T2 minus T1. So this will come out to be 0. So this is the value of the heat transfer, which we have just calculated as 0 or derived as 0. But in practice, we already know that adiabatic process is a process in which the heat transfer value is 0. So we have now going for a polytropic process. Now, like in case of a reversible adiabatic process, the first relationship was PV raised to power gamma is equal to constant. The second relationship was TV raised to power gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. And the third relationship was P divided by T raised to power gamma over gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. Here, in case of a polytropic process, we can replace this gamma by N actually. So this gamma can be replaced by N everywhere in each of these relationship. So it will become N minus 1, and here it will become N over N minus 1. So you can see here, once again, for a polytropic process, we have three relationships, and these are PV raised to power N is equal to constant, TV raised to power N minus 1 is equal to constant, and P divided by T raised to power N over N minus 1 is equal to constant. And we have already derived the relationship for the work transfer, which is P1 V1 minus p2 v2 divided by n minus 1, and p1 v1 is equal to mr t1 minus t2 divided by n minus 1. So I can say, now I can write the value of u2 minus u1, which is given as mcv t2 minus t1. It is the common formula for all the processes. It will never change, except in case of a constant temperature process, the value of change in internal energy will be zero. Otherwise, the equation is same. So now to calculate the value of delta Q, what I can do is, I can use the first law of thermodynamics for a process. It is given by delta Q is equal to du plus P delta W. So U2 minus U1, that is given by MCV T2 minus T1, and the W is given by MR T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1. So CV is given by R over gamma minus 1. So what I can do is, in place of CV here, I can put the value as R over gamma minus 1. M is written as it is T2 minus T1 minus MR N minus 1 into T2 minus T1. You can see here the T1 minus, it was T1 minus T2. Here it is T2 minus T1. That is why this plus sign is replaced here by the negative sign here. So you can see it here that now we can take certain terms common from both these terms. For example, this R is common, M is common, and T2 minus T1 is common in both these terms. So MR T2 minus T1 is taken as common, and first we are left with the 1 over gamma minus 1 minus 1 over n minus 1. And then when we simplify this equation, we get MCV T2 minus T1 n minus gamma over n minus 1. And if you will see it here, this is nothing but change in internal energy U2 minus U1. Okay, so that means if I have to remember this equation of the heat transfer, what I will do, I am writing Q1 to 2 is equal to change in internal energy, can be written as delta U. And if you remember the formula of delta U, it is given by MCV T2 minus T1. And CV is actually equal to R over gamma minus 1. So what you need to do is, you need to remember that the gamma minus 1 is already in the denominator when you are calculating the value of delta U. So what you can do is, once you know that the gamma minus 1 is already in the denominator, here you write n minus 1, and in the numerator you multiply by n minus gamma. So this is a way of remembering the value of change in internal energy, the value of heat transfer in case of a polytropic process. So this is one way of calculating the heat transfer in case of polytropic process. So let us calculate the value of heat transfer in a different fashion now. Now, once again, MT2 minus T1 into CV. This is the value of change in internal energy. And this was the factor which we have multiplied. This is the factor, same factor which is written here. Okay. So this value, which is on the right hand side in this circle, which is CV into N minus gamma over N minus 1, is written as CN. Other two factors, M into T2 minus T1, is taken as it is. So we get the value as MCN T2 minus T1. So once again, to remind you that this value of CN is nothing but it is equal to CV. And you remember that in case of CV, it is R over gamma minus 1. So because R over gamma minus 1 is already in the denominator, here you can write N minus 1 into N minus gamma. So it is a way to remember. So I can always say that in a polytropic process, heat transfer is given by M into CN into delta T. So this is the value of heat transfer. And what is CN? CN is the specific heat for the polytropic process. Now we have calculated the value of the heat transfer for a polytropic process in terms of the change in internal energy. Now we are going to calculate this value in terms of work transfer. So once again, starting from the basics, U1 to 2 is given by change in internal energy plus work transfer. So change in internal energy is MCV T2 minus T1, whereas the work transfer is given by MR T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1. This we got from the relationship, once again reminding you, P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. So here I have written the value of CV as R over gamma minus 1. Other two terms are same, M and T2 minus T1. Once again, MR same here, T2 minus T1 over gamma N minus 1 same here. So there is no change in the second term, whereas in the first term, instead of CV, we have written R over gamma minus 1. So we can also write this expression as MR over gamma minus 1 into T2 minus T1 minus MR T2 minus T1 divided by N minus 1. So instead of T2 minus T1, here I have taken T1 minus T2, I have taken T2 minus T1. So it's very easy now that you can see. But I have taken T1 minus T2 as so it can also be written as MR T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1 minus MR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. So this is what we have written. When we take MR T1 minus T2 as common, we are left with minus 1 over gamma plus minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 over N minus 1. And then we can simplify this equation. You can see this equation here. We have simplified it here. This minus 1 and this plus 1 will cancel out. And we are left with MR into T1 minus T2. This term N minus 1 is taken in the denominator here. Then gamma minus 1 N over gamma minus 1 is left here. So we can say that the value of Q1 to 2 is given by W1 to 2 into gamma minus N over gamma plus 1. So to make you understand how to remember it, there is once again a very simple method. See, we know that when we are writing W1 to 2, for W is given by P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1. So N minus 1 is already there in the denominator. So what you have to do, you multiply here by gamma minus 1 and gamma minus N. And this comes out to be the value of Q1 to 2. So that is how we can remember the value of the heat transfer in case of a polytropic process. So before I go to the numerical problem, I would like to tell you about all the equations which we have just derived. If I say that the volume is constant, in that particular case, the value of heat transfer is given by the relationship MCV T2 minus T1. If I take pressure is equal to constant, the value of heat transfer is given by MCP T2 minus T1. If I take temperature is equal to constant, then the value of work transfer and heat transfer are same. And you know that the work transfer is given by the equation P1 V1 log natural V2 by V1. And you know there are actually 8 relations for this particular case. The next case is PV raised to power gamma is equal to constant, which is reversible adiabatic process. In that particular case, the value of heat transfer will be 0. And the fifth case is PV raised to power N is equal to constant. In this particular case, the value of Q is given in 3 terms, where Q is equal to MCN delta T. So where the value of CN is given by CV into N minus 1 N minus gamma. The second value is in terms of change in internal energy, that is delta U multiplied by N minus 1 N minus gamma. And I can also write this in terms of work transfer. So I will be writing here gamma minus 1 gamma minus N. So I will end my lecture here only. एंड इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल बी डूइंग द न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स.